Good morning, students. How are you all? Hope you are fine. Today we are going to discuss about our surface areas and volumes. Subtopic is right circular cylinder. This is the right circular cylinder. This is the radius of base circle and this is the height. So bottom circle to top circle, distance is called height. Here is made up of one curved surface. This is the curved surface. And two congruent circles. These are the two congruent circles. Top and bottom. These are two congruent circles. A line joining center of the circular faces. Here a line joining center of the circular faces. Here bottom circle center is here. Top circle center is here. A line joining center of the circular faces and perpendicular to its base. This line is perpendicular to its base. Is called, so entire this figure is called right circular cylinder. Once again I repeat, is made up of one curved surface. This is the curved surface and two congruent circles. These are the two congruent circles, top and bottom. A line joining center of circular faces. Here a line joining center of circular faces. This is the line. This is also called as height. And perpendicular to its base. This line is perpendicular to its base. Base means here bottom circular diameter. Here bottom circular diameter is called base. This line height is perpendicular, always perpendicular to its base. So entire this diagram is called right circular cylinder. So our first formula from right circular cylinder, curved surface area of cylinder. So that is equals to curved surface area. Formula is perimeter of circle. So boundary distance, boundary length is called perimeter. Perimeter of the circle formula is 2 pi r into height. So this is the height, distance between the two circles. Distance between the two circles midpoint is called height. So that is equals to perimeter of the circle formula is 2 pi r into height is h. This is the curved surface area of cylinder formula 2 pi r h. So next our topic is total surface area, TSA of right circular cylinder. Here TSA means total surface area. So any right circular cylinder consists of two circles and one of the curved surface. Here this is the top end circle and this is the bottom one. So area of this circle formula is pi r square. So bottom area is also pi r square. So that is equals to substitute these values in our formula. Total surface area of right circular cylinder consists of two circles and one of the curved surface area. So that is equals to here pi r square plus 2 pi r h. So that is equals to here pi r square is 2 pi r square plus 2 pi r h. Here common term is 2 pi r. 2 pi r is the common term. Remaining terms are r plus h. This is the formula of total surface area of right circular cylinder. Once again I repeat, let us be observe a right circular cylinder. The right circular cylinder consists of two circles, that is first one top one and second one bottom. So this circle's area is pi r square and pi r square. These are congruent circles. So one of the curved surface area, here curved surface area of the cylinder is 2 pi r h. Already we obtained in our previous formula. Substitute these values in our total surface area. So that is equals to pi r square plus 2 pi r h. So that is equals to here pi r square is 2 pi r square plus 2 pi r h. Here common term is 2 pi r. Remaining terms are r plus h. This is the formula of total surface area of right circular cylinder. This is our first question from curved surface area of cylinders. So here this is the given figure. Find the curved surface area of the following cylinders. This is the given cylinder. Here height is 10 cm and the diameter is 7 cm. So here our radius formula is diameter by 2. So that is equals to 7 by 2. Result is 3.5 cm. So our measures are h is equals to height of the cylinder is 10 cm and radius is 3.5 cm. Substitute these values in our formula. So curved surface area of cylinder formula is 2 pi rh. So that is equals to 2 into pi means what is the approximate value of pi? 22 by 7 into r is 3.5 into height is h is 10 centimeters. So 7 how many times divides 3.5? So 0.5 times. So that is equals to 2 into 22 into 0.5 into 10, result is 5. So that is equals to 2 into 22 into 5, 5 2s are 10 into 22. So that is equals to 220 centimeters square. So finally, curved surface area of cylinder is 220 centimeters square. This is the final result. So next question, based on total surface area. So this is the question. Find the total surface area of following cylinders. So here the cylinder is, height is 7 centimeters and area of the bottom circle is 250 centimeters square. Here height is 7 centimeters and area of the bottom circle is 250 centimeters square. So here in top circle, bottom circle, both are congruent. So here area of the circle is 250 centimeters square. Formula, area of the circle formula is pi r square. So that is equals to 250. Here r square, pi transposes. So that is equals to 1 by 5. So 7 by 22. 250 into 7 by 22. R square is equals to, here the result of the 250 into 7 by 22 is 79.5. This is the approximate value of 81. So that is equals to r is square transposes to square root. Square root of 81, r is equals to 9. So here height of the cylinder is 7 centimeters, radius of cylinder is 9 centimeters. So substitute these values in our total surface area formula. So here height is 7 centimeters, radius is 9 centimeters. Substitute these values in our formula. Total surface area of cylinder is equals to 2 pi r into r plus h. Here pi is equals to 22 by 7, radius is 9 centimeters, r is 9 centimeters plus height is 7 centimeters. Substitute these values instead of pi and r and h. So that is equals to 2 into 22 by 7 value is 3.14. So decimal form of 22 by 7 is 3.14 into 9 into 16. So that is equals to, multiplication of this result is 904.32. This is the final result. So units are centimeter square. Here units are centimeter square. So this is our first question from Do This. Find the total surface area of the following cylinder. Here this is the first diagram. So here radius is 7 centimeters. Height of the cylinder is 10 centimeters. So here radius is 7 centimeters, height is 10 centimeters. Find the total surface area of the cylinder. So formula, 2 pi r into r plus h. This is the formula of total surface area of cylinder. So that is equals to 2 into pi means 22 by 7 into r. Here r is 7 centimeters into r plus h means 7 plus 10. So that is equals to into 7 divided by 7, both are cancel, remaining 2 into 22 into 7 plus 10 is 17. So that is equals to 22 is 44 into 17. So 44 into 17 result is 748 centimeter square. This is the total surface area of the cylinder of dimensions 7 centimeter is the radius, 10 centimeter is height. Next topic, volume of cylinder. So volume of cylinder formula is area of circle into height. Area of circle into height. So that is equals to area of circle formula, pi r square into height means h. So that is equals to pi r square h. This is the formula of volume of cylinder. Here r means radius, h means height. Once again I repeat, volume of cylinder formula is area of circle into height. So that is equals to area of circle is pi r square into height is h. So finally formula is pi r square h. Here units are cubic units. Exercise 10.2, third one, the question is depending on volume of the cylinder. So here a question, a metal cuboid of dimensions 22 centimeters, 15 centimeters, 7.5 centimeters, means dimensions of cuboid means length, breadth and height. Here the cuboid length is 22 centimeters, breadth is 15 centimeters, height is 7.5 centimeters. Was melted and cast into a cylinder. The entire cuboid is melted and cast into a cylinder. Here the cylinder of height 14 centimeters means, here the cylinder dimensions are height is 14 centimeters. What is its radius? Here radius is question mark. So radius of the cylinder is question mark. The cuboid melted and cast into a cylinder of height 14 centimeters. Then what is its radius? This is the question mark. Here the volume of cuboid is equals to volume of cylinder. Why? Because it is melted and cast into a cylinder. So the volume of cuboid is equals to volume of cylinder. So volume of cuboid formula is L into B into H. Here L is 22 centimeters, B is 15 centimeters, height is 7.5 centimeters. So that is equals to volume of the cylinder formula is pi r square H. Here pi is 22 by 7, r square means r square, this is our question mark, into height is 14 centimeters. So that is equals to here 7, how many times divides 14? 2 times. So transpose this 22 and 2. So that is equals to r square is equals to, here r square is equals to 15 into 22 into 7.5 by 22 into 2. So 22, 22 cancel. 2 how many times divides 15? 7.5 times. Here 7.5 into 7.5. 7.5 whole square is equals to r square. Here square transposes to square root. Here square root cancel. So finally our radius is equals to 7.5 centimeters. This is very important point. Volume of cuboid is equals to volume of cylinder. Here volume of cuboid is L into B into H. Volume of cylinder is pi r square H. Here so finally after that our simplification, r square is equals to 7.5 square. Square transposes to square root. So square root of 7.5 whole square. Square root cancel. So result r is 7.5 centimeters. Next question, exercise 10.2, fourth one. An overhead water tanker is in the shape of cylinder, has capacity of 61.6 cubic meters. Here the capacity is 61.6 cubic meters. The diameter of the tank is 5.6 meters. Here diameter is 5.6 meters and volume of the cylinder is 61.6 meters cube. Cubic meters is nothing but meters cube. So find the height of the water tank. Here the water tank height is question mark. Diameter is 5.6 meters. Volume is 61.6 meter cube. So here the volume of the cylinder is formula pi r square H. So volume is here 61.6 and radius is the diameter by 2 formula. So that is equals to 5.6 by 2. So that is equals to 2.8 meters. Here the radius is 2.8 meters and height is question mark. So the volume 61.6 is equals to pi means 22 by 7 into radius is 2.8. R square means 2.8 into again 2.8 into height is H. So H is equals to 7 how many times? 0.4 times divides 28. So that is equals to transpose these all terms into LHS. So 61.6 by 22 into 0.4 into 2.8. So H is equals to 61.6 by 22 into 0.4 into 2.8. So 22 into 0.4 into 2.8 result is 26.64 is equals to H. So 61.6 by 26.64. So height is equals to height of the cylinder is 2.31 centimeters. This is the final result. Here height of the cylinder is 2.31 centimeters. This is our 10th question from exercise 10.2. A one side open cylindrical drum, inner radius is 28 centimeters. Height is 2.1 meters. How much water you can store in the drum? So express in liters. So water should be expressed in liters. Here 1 liter is equals to 1000 cubic centimeters. CC means cubic centimeters. So this is the one side open cylindrical drum. Here the radius is 28 centimeters. So height is 2.1 meters. So first we have to change it into centimeters. Here 1 meter is equals to 100 centimeters. So here height is 2.1 meters. Here meter means 100 centimeters. So that is equals to 2.1 into 100 centimeters. Multiply 21 with 100. So 210 centimeters. Here radius is 28 centimeters. Height is 210 centimeters. Substitute these values in our formula. Volume is pi r square h. Here volume is equals to pi means 22 by 7 into radius is 28. R square means 28 into 28 into height is 210 centimeters. So that is equals to V is equals to here 7, 4 times divides to 28. So 22 into 4 into 28 into 210. Here 22 4 is 88 into 28 into 210. So volume is 517,440 centimeter cube. First we have to express in liters. Here 1 liter is equals to 1000 centimeter cube. So 1 centimeter cube is equals to 1 by 1000 liters. So multiply these results instead of centimeter cube here. So volume is equals to 517,440 into 1 by 1000 liters. So that is equals to volume is 517.44 liters. This is the final result. So drum can stores 517.44 liters of water. Okay, my dear students, remaining do these problems as your homework. If you have any doubts in this session, please contact my number. Thank you.